Hello, and welcome back to another video. I'm ZipperSpark, and you're watching my barely modded Factory Tech Let's Play series. Last time, we installed this mining machine up there, and it's been mining away. It got all the way to this block. It stopped because it ran out of parts. I still have not done anything to automate the parts, and so it's a manual process and takes a lot of running back and forth and putting things in and such, but it's making a lot of stuff, mostly cobble here, but we get a bunch of these ore chunks, and then a few of the actual ores. So these ore chunks, what they're good for, if you recall, we can turn these ones into the sparkling ground ore chunks. And from them, when the centrifuge, well, the magnetic centrifuge, we can get lapis and redstone. These other ones, very similar. But you can get gold or copper from the electroplater, but you need sulfuric acid. Or from the magnetic centrifuge, you can get a ferrous ore pile with gravel. And from this, you can throw in a regular centrifuge, get nickel and iron. And that you can smelt as you would expect. So we can pretty much get all the resources we need, at least for a while, out of these. And I don't know if you noticed the Y level we were at down there. It was at Y32, so about halfway down to bedrock. So that's, you know, we can keep babysitting that, or we can move on and see what we need to do. So I wanted to look into what was needed to make these centrifuges, because we need to grind them, which means we'll probably need a better way to automate the drill bits. Right now we don't have drill bits automated. We have the metal cutting machine. We can throw the is that even where you make those? I'm getting confused now. I think it is, yeah. Recipes. Grindstone makes the blunt, and the metal cutter makes the, yeah. Grindstone turns, yeah, the metal cutter turns the nickel into the drill bits. And then you sharpen them in the grindstone. Okay. So we don't have a... we do have a metal cutting machine and grindstones over here. But we'll probably want another one in the chain for automation. For that. Put that over here, I suppose. And... yeah, this is kind of annoying to have this redstone all the way up here. I was thinking of a way to handle the automatic refilling of these a bit better. And what my thoughts on it were to have a buffer that held, because right now, I mean, my buffer is hoppers and things. I have a buffer that held all of, say, all the basic gears. So there would be somewhere, like a double chest or something, that was full of basic gears. And then when one of the machines needed one, it would send a signal to say, hey, I need one, and then it would get it. Whereas now, if it needs one, the hoppers just feed it one, and then the hopper sends a signal that says, hey, I just handed one off. I need a refill. So. Yeah. But let's look at the centrifuge. So the centrifuge needs a basic gear, which is simple. Advanced motor, which we've made tons of. A shaft, which is simple. And then the magnetic centrifuge just needs some magnets, circuit boards, and then the centrifuge. The magnets you put in a magnetizer. Requires an AC redstone current. The easiest way to do that is to throw a lever down. See if I can get all that lever. And then just hold right click. But that's not automated in any way. So another easy way to do that is I guess I need a block. Just a simple redstone circuit. So throw a torch on one side and wire it up with dust. And if you connect it, it will quick flash and then burn out the torch. But if you put a repeater down on the one tick delay, it will burn out the torch. But if you do it slower, come on, there we go. It won't burn it out. Now, there are ways to get faster clocks. Namely, where's the comparator? That's not a comparator. That's the easiest way. So here you've got, I think it, you know, every redstone tick or two game ticks, you've got the power alternating. Probably one of the easiest fast clocks to make is a comparator on subtraction mode. So probably hook that up to a magnetizer. So let's look at the magnetizer. Magnetizer, it's this guy. So we need some gold, advanced motors, wires, shafts, super simple. So let me get the parts and components put together and I'll be right back. All right, I have two centrifuges ready to go. One is going to be the part for that, but I need these magnets first, which means I need the magnetizer, which means I need to grab a couple more wires. All right. So this, here, let me show you. So before it was a torch here, and then the power level here would be 15, 14, 13, and that would subtract it, give it 2, 1, 0, and so forth. Well, that, if you don't know, flashing redstone causes a lot of lag. And if you can get it to only flash one power level, like it is here, then it reduces the amount of lag. And in order to do that, you need anywhere from 28 to 41 items in a furnace. So, you know, just like have a stack of something will do. And then that will, you know, make it so that this pulses on 0 and 1. Another way to do it, if you don't want to use the redstone at all, is to just have two observers pointing to each other. That's the same pulse rate. And if you push it in with a piston, it's actually a different clock than if you just place it by hand. Let's see if we can see that at all. Yeah, you can see it, it's a bit slower. But if I retract this, then it goes faster. And that's just the way the observers behave. So if I put my magnetizer here, put in some wires and some motors. So let me get a couple stacks of those, make a stack of, what am I missing? Oh, iron nuggets. Three, four. All right. So this is ready to go. I put these in and it works. So I've got the observer here giving the pulse to it, and simple as that. Now if I turn that off, they wouldn't go. So you actually do need the pulsing. So yeah. Don't need this. Because two observers right next to each other will work. And this is a lot lag friendly as well, to have them just observers in there with nothing really attached. Alright, so we've got our magnets for the magnetic centrifuge. We just need that circuit board, which we should have here. And now we can make that. Okay, so we'll put this over here, and I see you out there. I don't have any arrows on me now. So I'll probably set up over here. I don't know exactly where I should actually make an actual farm for this. Although I don't know how much cactus I really need. I probably have enough already. I'll probably just tear this down and call it good. Just remember not to, well, I mean, there's a desert right over there, so it doesn't matter too much, probably. Yep. Okay. So, be right back. All right, so I got these down, and I got, a handful of parts in there, not anything near, like, automated style or anything, of course, but, if you look at the uses of this ground iron ore, you can smelt it, which is how we've been doing it before. Throw it in the centrifuge, we get a nickel nugget as well as the iron dust. So let's try that. It does use these a bit, but we get a little bit of profit of nickel for each one we put through. Well, that's nice. Let's look at this. Put one of these through. Actually, let me grab one of the other ones as well. Grab a stack of both, I guess. Because we're going to want to play with them all anyways. And put one of those through. Okay, so we've got these ones and these ones. So, the uses for this. So, sulfuric acid. I don't have the electroplating set up yet. Let's throw it through here. We get the gravel and the ferrous pile. That looks like it's done. Okay, so one of these. There's ore pile. Gravel, the uses on this. And smelt it straight into iron. Throw it through the centrifuge, get nickel as well as iron. Or we can furnace it. Let's put it here. Nickel and iron. So, gives us a sweet little profit. Throw this in here. This should give us lapis and redstone. Sure enough. All right. What are the other uses on this? Oh, just smelt it to the iron. But if I go here, oh, this one. There we go. Now I can furnace them all. And yep, I'm gonna get my iron there. So I'll probably run out of parts and stuff, but definitely something that's pretty cool. We've got a way to increase our yield, but we have to keep feeding it things. And as mentioned, this is the only, like, well, not the only, it was one of the biggest annoyances of Factory Tech Mod is the parts. You have to keep feeding them, and the abysmal rate at which they wear out. Now, you can mess with it. Let's see, where is it? Right here. Oh, there's no config here, so I can't show you in the game, but I think, actually, let me double check that. I think you can. Hold tight. Well, I was able to double check. There is a config file that indicates how much. There's four numbers, and if you look in here, kind of says machine info. Just look at here, for example. So there's a config file where all these numbers are, and you can kind of configure it. So for the metal cutting machine, it needs a blade and a gear, and the minimum operations for the blade is 8, for the gear is 6, and then the chance each operation after that for it to break, and then how much it increases over time. So you're guaranteed 8 operations. Every operation after that has a 10% chance to break. The 9th operation has a 10% chance to break. And then as it goes on and on, there's it's like 110% increase of that 10% chance. So I guess that would mean like it's like about 11% chance for the 10th operation. And, you know, so on as it goes up. And then the salvage is, once it does break, that's 50% chance that you'll get the dull blade back. 50% chance it'll just be gone. So it's definitely something like the pack developers could tweak and try and, you know, adjust the balance. I personally feel that the default balance is a little off, especially when it kind of has to compete in packs for against other tech mods. And in like a vanilla setting like this, it just seems like all you're doing is setting up crazy things to automate it. And honestly, the only purpose is because the parts break so much. But, I mean, this is a fun little setup, but like this whole setup is to run itself. The chop saw here is the only thing that doesn't have something automatically being inserted into it in order to, feed a part into the other thing. And I very well could set up the quartz blocks to be inserted into here to be automatically chopped and fed into the circuit scribes. So I do think the default balance is off. Whether or not I will tweak the balance of this barely modded series, I don't know. I guess it depends on how frustrated I get. And one of the things, like the miner there, you can't see it. I can just step outside here. So the miner there, it has, well, if we look at it, so the mining machine, where is that? Right here. So you're guaranteed 14, 16, and 16. And then this is almost ridiculous. A 20% chance to break the motor. And then a 10% for the circuit and the drill. I mean, yeah, it's fine, but it's almost ridiculous. The how fast it just eats through the parts. And I mean, it's fine that you want the parts to break, but this was probably, I mean, counting a stack as 64, not the four that it actually stacks up to here in the, I guess I can't even see it. Yeah, these only stack up to four, but counting a stack of 16, I probably used like probably two stacks of each, except for the motors. The motors, yeah, I probably used two stacks of that, and so, yeah. I probably will end up tweaking the numbers a bit. I don't know exactly by how much just yet, but I did kind of want to get this series to be more enjoyable than it's turning out to be. And I think with as fast as these parts are breaking, it's not very enjoyable at all. Maybe all I'll do is increase the number of minimum operations. Maybe I'll dramatically decrease the break chance. Not sure, but I haven't done anything extra with the villagers. The nitwit. Doesn't even run away. Truly is a nitwit. Here's another one. Oh, I don't feel like doing this right now. All right. Well, I think that is going to be it for today. I did plan on putting in more time on this episode. The original plan I had was to try and automate some things, but then I got in game and I remembered that it's such a pain because the parts break so much that you really have to automate a ton of things. So yeah, I probably will still automate them, but making it so that I don't have to automate it so much, or the before the automation is done. Because, like, seriously, after I logged off, not logged off, cut the last episode, probably ran to and from that mining machine out there at least 20 plus times with handfuls of parts to feed it. And then, as you saw, I only got halfway down. So, yeah. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, leave a like. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And leave me a comment. Tell me what you think. If you think the balance of the part usage is fine as is, or if it needs to be tweaked a bit. I think if I were to create a mod pack with all this stuff in it, I probably would tweak the parts so much that you didn't really need to use a lot. But yeah. Factory Tech is a powerful mod. Simple, powerful. But it's one of those that's hard to balance. Yeah, that's what I'll say for now. It's hard to balance. Anyways, talk to you later, guys. Bye-bye.